was the best of times. It was the blurst of times. It was the best. It was the best. It was the best of times. It was the blurst of times. It was the best. You stupid monkey!
For anyone who's played the Trials series, good news! Trials is back and more fliptastic than ever. Trials Rising is the latest outing in the series since the well-received Trials Fusion and the definitely released dual game universe spin-off Trials of the Blood Dragon. Players will once again hop on a variety of trial bikes and navigate a bevy of beautiful tracks, each more scrumdiddlyumptious than the last.
Mom Bibbleyunction's bar, how does he do it?
My dear boy, do you ask a fish how it swims?
No.
Or a bird how it flies?
No.
No, sorry, you don't. They do it because they were born to do it.
One big bonus point early on is that the game still looks pretty. They've polished up the backgrounds and interchanging environments to make full use of the world around the player. Likewise, the soundtrack to the game is pretty bang on. I'd liken it to the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater soundtracks of old. Well-rounded and well-suited to the game. But let's also get one of the big downsides out of the way early on. This game has loot boxes, in this case called gear boxes. They give players access to new clothes and bike skins. They come thick and fast while you're leveling up, but can also be purchased for in-game currency. They're as cheap and as nasty as they sound. Combined with the fact that you'll often see the same items coming up, it makes the progression system feel unnecessary. Trials games have an uncanny knack of making you feel like you've completely forgotten how to do even the simplest of tasks. The first 5 minutes you'll spend relearning how to balance yourself in this world of incredibly bizarre physics, like a baby giraffe finding its feet for the first time.
Sure what to do with my hands.
Be good just to hold them down by your side. Yeah, great.
Well, we're real happy with what was going on. And at the end of the day, you know, you gotta be happy.
As a concept, the Trial series is brilliant. It sticks to Bushnell's Law. It's very easy to learn and difficult to master. You can absolutely bumble your way through a level and make it through by the skin of your teeth, balancing precariously on a single wheel with your body heading in the wrong direction. But the satisfaction comes in perfectly nailing a backflip where you shouldn't, or traversing a course without falling. The controls are equally simplistic, and the combination of power, braking, leaning, and traction will have you constantly finding new and more creative ways to make your way across the track.
Parkour!
There's a new training ground series of events, which will mean that players new and old can learn or relearn the mechanics of the game. And rather than just being tacked on, this training system will push you to learn increasingly more complex skills and techniques. There's even a series of advanced courses which will push your skills to the max and opens up new possibilities for more hard-to-reach sections of the tracks. Trials Rising offers up a new system of contracts and sponsors who will task a player with completing skill activities on each course. It's great that you finished that last course. Now do that again with a dozen front flips. The variety of tracks and challenges on offer are pretty impressive, although fans returning to the series will wonder if there's really anything more to this than minor graphical improvements and a few new maps. The hardest part about Trials is really the difficulty level. It feels like it's been knocked up significantly since Fusion. Players are gifted with some beginner levels to start with, which give you a feel for how to interact with the world, but immediately they crank it up and continue to do so over subsequent levels. It'll make it harder for younger players to enjoy the game. Likewise, anyone easily frustrated by a trial and error style game will probably find the temptation to throw your controller Rising. Trials Rising feels like the natural child of Fusion and Blood Dragon. The level of fun and attention to detail on the maps is something to be commended. The pleasing variety of the solid soundtrack and the constant challenge of multiplayer will have players coming back for more. Although a finicky menu system, gearboxes, and lackluster upgrades considering the time passed since the launch of its parent games, makes me wonder if it's actually a worthy successor or just another regular member of the family. For all the latest on Trials Rising and other games, subscribe to Shaken Not Nerd on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Or you can subscribe to the Shaken Not Nerd podcast on your favourite podcatcher.
You're on Saturday. and a little curious.
You wouldn't even hear me.